friends, welcome to our online classes. Today we are going to discuss about the tissue. Tissue is our point. Now see, you all know it very well that all the living organisms is made up of single unit. This single unit is called the cell. So whether it is an animal or plants, all are made up of by this cell. So these group of the similar kind of cells means the group of the similar kind of cells are termed as a tissue. So the tissue is the group of similar kind of cells that gives rise to the specific function. And Bichat in 1972, Bichat is the scientist who discovered about the tissue in 1972, and the study of the tissue is called the histology. So we can take any example, either of our respiratory system, our digestive system, our nervous system. So I am taking the example of digestive system. So the group of the tissue give rise to the organs. So the cell, group of the cell consists tissue, and the group of the tissues consists an organ. So now from the our food pipe to our anus, all the system of digestive system consists of a similar kind of cells. This perform the specific function of digestive system. So the tissues are divided into main two categories as a plant tissue and another is a animal tissue. So plant tissue is divided into three main categories: meristematic tissue, and second one is permanent tissue. So according to the name, plant tissues are mostly found only in the plants. So now meristematic tissues, these are the tissues that are found at the apical region of the plant body, means on the root apical portion or at the shoot apex, we can say. So this promote the growth of the plant. These meristematic tissues are divided into three type of categories. Number one is apical meristematic tissue. Now apical meristematic tissue, these cells, tissues, cells are specific, having the capacity for the cell division. They are found at the apex of the root and shoot, means these are responsible for the growth of the whole plant. Now come to the next one. Second, lateral meristematic tissues. Lateral meristematic tissues are especially found in the dicotyledons plants. Below the carpocambium, these type of lateral meristematic tissues are found. These are less in the number and they promote the growth of the width of the plant, means they are responsible only for the thickening of the plant parts. Now third one is intercalary meristematic tissue. Intercalary meristematic tissues are especially found in the leaf and at the internodes of the stem, and they are responsible for the growth of the size of the leaf and size of the stem. So these are three main parts of the meristematic tissue. Now tomorrow, or maybe in our next online class, next permanent tissue we will discuss.